Hi guys, today I will show you how to measure a voltage on a 12 volt battery, how to check the charging voltage and how to test the rectifier or voltage regulator. I will start with the battery voltage. A healthy 12 volt battery should display at least 12.4 volts. The measurement should be taken at least half an hour after charging or driving. For these measurements we will need a multimeter. First I will set it to 20 volts DC. The red probe goes on the positive terminal of the battery with a plus, and the black probe goes on the negative terminal. 12.9 volts is a good value for a battery, so this one is in good condition. Next, I'll measure the charging voltage of the battery, which is the voltage the battery receives when the scooter is running. We can leave the probes directly on the battery. All we need to do is start the engine. Here we see an idle value of approximately 14.5 volts, which is good. 14.4 is desirable. This is a good result. Now let's measure at full throttle. The value here should not exceed approximately 14.8 volts. Now this measurement is also within acceptable range. Now what I mentioned earlier, after charging let the battery rest at least half an hour. Immediately after charging or driving, incorrect or inflated values might be shown. After half an hour it should show around 12.9 volts again. At this point the measurement is complete and everything is in order. If the values don't match or if you encounter other issues like lightning problems, you will need to test the rectifier. On most scooters, the rectifier is located under the bodywork. On some other scooters, it's under the seat. On my scooter, it's under the bodywork. You can access the rectifier by removing the screws here and on the other side. One screw at the front and two at the bottom. Once the front bodywork is removed, you'll find the rectifier here. These cables come from the alternator, and if you watched my video on alternator measurements, you will recognize the colors. Green is ground, yellow is lightning coil, and white-red is charging coil. Now we have also a red cable here, which we didn't have in the alternator. The cable carries current to the battery, so it's the charging current. To measure the voltage arriving at the voltage regulator, I'll test with the connector unplugged. I'll first measure the incoming voltage from the lightning coil, the yellow cable, and the charging coil, the white-red cable. I will set the multimeter to 200 volts AC and start the measuring the voltage coming from the lightning coil. Now the black probe of the multimeter goes to the green cable, the ground, and the red probe goes to the yellow cable. Depending on the engine speed, the voltage here should range between 14 and 70 volts AC. If you are finding this video helpful, hit that thumbs up button and consider subscribing for more videos. It looks good so far. Now I will perform the same measurement for the charging coil. The black probe can stay on the green cable and the red probe goes to the white-red cable, the charging coil. Here too, the voltage should be between 14 and 70 volts AC. This is also looking good so far. And finally, let's check whether the voltage at the voltage regulator is correctly regulated. Keep the black probe on the ground cable and place the red probe on the red cable, which outputs the regulated voltage. Now it's important to connect the plug, otherwise the voltage won't be regulated by the rectifier. Now that the voltage regulator or the rectifier is connected, the AC voltage is converted back to DC. For that reason, I will set the multimeter back to 20 volts DC and the regulated voltage here might slightly deviate upwards from the charging voltage measured at the battery. Now, if the incoming voltage from the lightning and charging coils, means yellow and white-red cables, is correct, but the regulated voltage and the battery's charging voltage are not, it's most likely that the voltage regulator or the rectifier, this piece, is defective and you should replace it. If the incoming voltage is already incorrect, then you should test the alternator. I'll put the link to the alternator testing video in the video description. That's it for now. If you have any questions or would like to discuss, feel free to comment below the video. If you liked the video, I would appreciate a thumbs up. You are also welcome to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any more videos. And with that, safe travels!